Hello and welcome to my recording session. This is number vlog 6. So let me shortly introduce myself. Who am I? My name is Alexander Arlovsky. I am a full stack developer, freelancer. So here you have my email, my website, my Google Android app. So what kind of services do I provide? I do requirements engineering for my clients. I developing software for my clients. I helping my clients to make sure that their software running correctly. And I help random people, which can be student or people who want to switch the job and want to work in Germany. So if you're interested, just contact me and I hopefully can help you further. This is a short introduction about me. And now to the actual stuff which I want to show you today. So as you hopefully already know, I developing my own game in part-time setup, and what you see about it's a new stuff which I have created today, made with Unity of course. So basically I would speak about the challenges and how much time it did took me to do that. It took me quite a while to gather the stuff. Once again, looking for the suitable assets always time consuming. Yes, I know you can create the assets, but I'm not a 3D level designer by all means, or designer at all, but I love to set up scenes, to work with actual already done set assets, so it's always easy. One interesting observation, as you can clearly see here, I have here a force field. This is an asset from the Unity Asset Store. Most of the assets which I use are freely available for, and can be used in the commercial game. Legally obtained, of course. And yeah, so basically, this is a room where kind of plant room where electricity produced by this sun. This actually should represent the sun, artificial sun of course, and then storage of hydrogen, and sometimes probably critical moments you can run here from coal ore. And yeah, this thing don't seem to be much, but believe me, it was some work to do. And yeah, I'm enjoying to doing the parts of the game, like what I have previously show you, that is not all the game which I want to do. So it's kind of first small steps into the right direction. But yeah, I continue to work on my game in part-time. I used Unity 3D, of course, maybe you didn't notice, but I always mentioned that I love to work with Unity because Unity is pretty fast and pretty nice and friendly in the way how you as can enter into the experience with Unity 3D. And yeah, so sometimes I'm pretty fast, and sometimes it just take time to find proper assets or just to adjust the assets in the way how I want to use it. But I was pretty lucky, but it took some time to figure it out how to generate this force field. And once again, I did not touch any code for this scene, so it's all pre-made by the people who have created the assets. I am just using them in my way, which I want for my game. And basically, I think that is it. I have created another room, but it's not nothing really spectacular in my point. And yeah. It's kind of interesting exposure which I'm doing right now to me. I'm not by any means a professional game designer or developer, but I have some background, pretty big background actually, in software development, and I know how to program the stuff. But if you ask me, what is the main challenges in Unity 3D, I will say working with the assets. I mean, if you have assets not directly from Unity store, it takes some time to get it through to the Unity 3D engine, because you need to make sure that all material, all shaders are correct, that the stuff is represented actually as it was supposed to be, as it advertised by the creator of the asset. So, and for me, I'm pretty lucky actually. I'm not using any big commercial assets which are actually available, because I mean, range of the commercial assets pretty big, and I respect the work of the people, of course. I recently spoke with one of the designer, which actually I used one of his assets and actually paid for his work. But I don't think that I will be, for me, from my side, basically, would be pretty necessary to heavily invest into the creation of an additional assets, because most stuff which you want to do is already was done by somebody, maybe not on the level which you want to polish, level which you expect or hope to, but for smaller people, for people who like, I mean small businesses, not in this size, but for people like for small businesses which want to just try something new, Unity 3D is pretty great. And I must say, I actually updated my Unity 3D editor once again, but no problems at all. The quality actually did improved, as I said earlier, and this is kind of maybe great words from independent guy, because I have no advertisement relations with Unity community at all, but I just think how I experience the development, and I say with such curve of development and iteration, when I don't hit any hurdles with game logic or managing resources of the game, I say it's pretty cool. Actually, Unity engine itself, for example, for this force field part, it did tell me that I need to decide whether I want to have it in the way that is performant enough. And I did set up, and it's really actually better in performance. So people who developing Unity 3D, by all means, taking care that the user of Unity 3D engine would experience the most positive, would get the most positive experience. But I think I'm babbling through. Next week I have already projects, not Unity. Yeah, pity. But I would continue. I have the things which you actually see, and I think I don't tell anyone yet. It's all basically one big major stuff. But secondary, actually I want to say not secondary, but rather next move for me would be creating another logic in the game. And I'm doing this in the way that I can present my ideas. So maybe not all things wired in, like for example T-poses for robots, because things can change and maybe it does not suit for my story. Still, this is still a prototype. I'm only one guy who doing this work. But I like it. I have no regrets doing this. This is kind of pretty amazing experience for me, and it continues, and I sincerely want to thank you for watching this, and stay tuned. Maybe over next week I will post new stuff about my progress. I have another project, I should mention it. It's a web portal for people who want to organize their job activity in more meaningful way, and it allows to insert job application into this portal freely, because this portal will be run by any people who can know enough information about how to run stuff in Docker distributed type systems. But I should mention this, and thank you once again for watching. If you like it, you can hit the bell, hit the subscribe button, and leave a comment. If it doesn't mean not mean to me or to what I'm doing in Unity, I would not delete it. So sorry for bubbling through. This is it. Work in progress. It continues, and hopefully next year half, basically rough alpha would be made, would be done. I hope this is not 100% in stone, but pretty amazing what it can achieve with Unity. And that's it. Thank you.